What is going on, guys? Dylan Merway here, and welcome to a brand new, actually pretty massive project I'm going to be undertaking on this channel, and that is called Gran Turismo 6. Gran Turismo 6 was created and developed by Polyphony Digital Incorporated. It was released in December of 2013 for the PlayStation 3. It was the last Gran Turismo 6, and personally I consider it an expansion of 5 because it has all the cars from that game, plus the DLCs, amounting to a massive amount of 1,200 cars. That's basically all the car tubs I have that are holding up my computer so I can record. That's all those cars multiplied by about 5. And that's how big the car collection is in Gran Turismo 6. We are going to enter our name and read this note from the Gran Turismo Association. Greetings from the Gran Turismo Association. Our mission, to help you reach your highest potential as a race car driver. Let's get started. Call ourselves Dylan. Merway. Now, personally, I've never really played a lot of Gran Turismo games. As a kid, I played the demo of 5. I played Prologue once. This game, obviously, which it's like Midnight Club. You need to save your money, otherwise you're screwed. And I played Gran Turismo 3 A-Spec a lot when I was a kid. So, anyways, let's jump right in. This is Brands Hatch, one of Britain's legendary racetracks, the site of many key moments in racing history. Essentially, this is basically just a lap around the track. Basically, all it is just cruise around the track. So anyways, controls, I'll go over in a few moments. While it goes in auto drive mode, there's a driving line that you can put around this track, which you're gonna have to follow quite a bit. Hit the brakes which is the square button to slow down, and hit the brakes. Triangle is reverse, and so far select is your change view button. Nothing is currently assigned to the e-brake portion, which would be the circle button later. And basically it's nothing too hard. Just basically you're cruising around Brands Hatch. So we're gonna go ahead and blow past this. No, I don't wanna restart. I don't wanna restart, damn it. I wanna exit. The thing to note too with Gran Turismo 5 and 6. Oh, message. You've completed the track day, Murs. Great job. As a reward, we have given you some money to get you started. Use the credits to buy your first car. To buy a car, click the dealerships button. Why not start out by buying the Honda Fit RS 2010? But what if I don't want to buy this car? Anyways, what I was saying earlier, with Gran Turismo 5 and 6, there is an option to put your custom music in this game, which is what I'll probably be doing instead of the game soundtrack. So I'll probably turn the volume a little lower than I originally do for my other Let's Plays. This car is basically enough. This here is where you can figure out cars and how it works. So if the view gallery is lit up, that means the car's got a detailed interior. So we have colors. We have the orange, Sunset Orange 2, Blue Metallic, Crystal Black, Polished Metal Metallic, Premium Yellow Part Pearl 2, Premium White. So I'm going to paint this bad boy blue. is we're going to be doing this cup by cup, so one cup per episode. Congratulations on buying your first car. Each car has a performance point rating, which gives you an idea of its capabilities. Honda Fit RS10 is 346. Some races will require a certain number of points, so it'll be something you'll need to keep your eye on. And the dealerships offer a massive variety of cars. Again, going back to the car totals I was talking about earlier. And to basically find a car, select the dealerships button. In the My Home screen, see the list of manufacturers. By selecting recommended cars, you can see cars based on where you're at in your career or listed by categories such as, you know, touring cars, Le Mans, dirt rally cars, current cars, classic cars, exotics. Even NASCAR was in this game. This is so far the second and probably final time NASCAR will be in Gran Turismo 6 because Gran Turismo Sport has apparently gone through the FIA, which means you can't drive Chase Elliott's car around Brands Hatch. I'm sorry. Anyways, so what I was talking about with the custom soundtrack feature, Gran Turismo 5, we'll get to the Novice Cup later, which the races won't take too long. Gran Turismo 5, heavy option for custom soundtrack is right on the back of this box here. If you can see, read past all the Spanish. And so does Gran Turismo 6. We're going to go into our music. We're going to play any of these songs in the playlist. So we're going to play One Call Away by Chingy. And for our first race, we're going to play Almost Easy. And, you know, we really don't need to be using Slideshow a lot unless I'm probably taking, like, pictures and, you know, saving replays as I go. Yeah. Anyways, I give to you Chingy, his song One Call Away. And let's jump right in to the Sunday Cup. Two races. First race is going to be High Speed Ring. At first, you're going to see six cars, and their maximum was six cars per race. But as you progress, there's going to be eight, there's going to be 10, there's going to be 12. The NASCAR races have 16, even though most of it's just duplicates of certain drivers. So we have two laps. It's going to total about 4.97 miles, and the winner gets 4,000 points. And the first race of Gran Turismo 6 is green. Gonna be flying past Ace Hutuati for sixth, for fifth. Be flying around off of this turn, then going into the something that totally doesn't look like a vagina. Get four spots from Amrojas. Sorry if I butcher these names. They're not, you know, most of these are. It's a lot of worldwide people, so you're going to see a lot of guys from Brazil, Italy, Germany, Czechoslovakia, things like that. Going to be passing, we pass by U Villegas for fourth from Spain. We're going to pass by Paul Contreras for second. Provided he doesn't cut me off. Bro, get out of my way. I got a faster car from 2010. You got a car that looks like it belongs in Back to the Future. So get out of my way. And basically how this is going to work is I'm going to progress through the career mode mainly, but I'm going to be talking about, you know, the Goodwood Festival Speed, which was a thing in Gran Turismo 5. And I'm also going to be doing the Lunar Exploration Missions, which is I'll be talking about in a later episode. See if I can get a inside lane on Robert Doyle, who I think is driving the same car as me. We are brothers. You're going to move out of my way. Oh, he's got a Lupo. Ugh. But then again, this car is not that attractive either. I mean, it's a great choice for a first car if your parents are going to pick the car for you. But honestly, it looks like a clown car. And sooner or later, there's going to be an idiot trying to race it. Unlike the other racing games that involve car customization and money in career mode that I've done, such as, you know, Underground 1, 2, Midnight Club. By the way, Hot Pursuit 2010 was canceled to make room for this game. Otherwise, I'd be stressed beyond all belief. So we come off the last turn. We are going to win the first race at High Speed Ring. Only one of those cars I recognize, and that's my car. So I'm probably going to turn the music up a few notches, because I do have some pretty good songs set to play in this game. Congratulations to win on winning your first race. And you managed to win on your first try. This race really is not that hard when you think about it. And the Gran Turismo Association says I've shown some potential as a top-notch driver. In career mode, you'll earn stars and credits based on your performance. Now get out there and try to clear all the novice events. Time to go to race two. Anyways, what I've kind of neglected to talk about, Gran Turismo 6, there's a couple new things introduced in this game past the newer cars. They've introduced lunar exploration missions, where you're going to have 3 missions, and you're on the moon in low gravity conditions. So, horn, windshield, wow, alright. Car settings. I have a horn. My god, dude. I have a freaking horn. Alright. Let's go to Autumn Ring Mini. Just under a mile. It's going to give us 3 laps around this joint. I'm probably going to be picking some cars from the recommended section as well. So, be sure to tune in for that. And if you have this game, please tell me what recommended cars you want for certain cups. And you know what cars I need to pick, cars I need to sell, because it'd be pointless to, you know, pour all my hopes and dreams into them, things like that. Or, once I build up enough stock of a collection of cars, tell me which one to use for certain events, provided you have this game, because I'm not going to go through all 1,200 cars. Go. Let go. Ready? I'm going to crank up the volume here. Ready, boogity, boogity, boogity. We're racing an Autumn Ring Mini. By the way, for the NASCAR stuff, I'm still going to have, like, the 2013 NASCAR intro. play, provided I either pick that car or you know, any of the 2011 DLC or any of the cars from the original game. You'll just have to wait and see. And not even a corner in, we're already making a bid for fourth and possibly third if we can get by this Prius, which I have no idea why Toyota let them let Polyphony put a Prius in a game. The Prius, honestly, is probably the gayest car I've seen. I mean, if it's your car you're driving to school, honestly, I feel sorry for you. But you got some major balls driving a Prius to school, because I'm surprised nobody's beating the living piss out of them. Anyways, we're going to be creeping up on this white-ish car with my blue Honda. Honda with Jane Fonda in it. So we're going to... It's like it's a it's a Mazda Roadster, which I saw at a car show a couple months back. And this means we're going to take the lead on this last lap coming to the white flag. And slowly cruising to the white flag, too. Jesus Christ. Cruising down out there through something that looks pretty, this section of course looking relatively similar to the Brighton Grand Prix, which actually was going to premiere this Sunday, 11 a.m. using the NASCAR on Fox intro. First thing, we haven't seen that since Talladega, don't you think? Be coming off the last turn. And we got it. So this car is fast enough to get you through all the novice events. But when you get to National B, you're probably going to have to either A, look in the recommend section, or just, you know, pour some upgrades into this thing. But you can't be willy-nilly about upgrades like you are in Midnight Club, because the upgrades you do can and will sometimes screw you over. Sunday Cup is out of the way. You can do 2 cups per video. We've opened up the Amateur Cup. We have Brands Hatch, Grand Valley East, and Willow Springs International Raceway. Lego. There's number one here at Brands Hatch, the smaller course. Save up as much money as I can. We're coming around to take the green. Here at Brands Hatch. Got 2 laps, but as you progress, the races will get longer. There will be more opponents to pass. I guarantee you, the go-kart races are going to be very frustrating. The reason I did this, and I'm probably going to be pumping a lot of episodes out, is because I'm half trying to balance this and, you know, working at Lowe's, which, so far, I don't want to be, you know, coming home 8 at night and just cramming Gran Turismo and Midnight Club episodes in, and NASCAR 4 episodes in, trying to finish up Season 2 on that game, because that sucks. That's why I kind of decided to X out Need for Speed Hot Pursuit for a while. At least until something comes, you know, frees up. And especially NASCAR 08 is going to be put on hold. Well, season two of that game, aka the last season, it's going to be put on hold for a moment. And we're going at top speed of 95 miles an hour. Totally. Gonna be passing by an old, crapped out Civic. surprised they haven't riced it yet. The rice is real. And so, kind of put NASCAR weight on the back burner for a moment. I've put Shark Tale on the back burner since, well, January, and I'm probably gonna start that up as well, because it's a lot shorter than this. To be perfectly honest. Also, I'm kind of putting Simpsons game on the back burner too, and kind of playing through the practice file of that. Currently, I'm halfway through and playing through the part where Homer and Lisa are in some Japanese game on a practice file in that game. So, anyways, we've won the first race of Amateur Cup. And we've got some more, though. And apparently this game likes my rock music. This game loves me some rock. A lot of these songs you've probably known from other racing games, such as this next song that you've known from Most Wanted. Let's go Grand Valley East Racing. In this song, which you know from NASCAR Thunder 2004. Alrighty, time to go race two at Grand Valley East and cruising around Herald of the King. Because we're the king of Gran Turismo 6. Well, we can't say that yet. Here at Grand Valley, it's kind of a relatively simple road course in a way. And I debated replacing RP on the schedule with this course, but then it would have been too many road courses in order to, you know, shake things up a bit. And besides, this road course doesn't seem much of a road course. It's more of a oval that can't sexually identify as a racetrack. We're catching the Volkswagen Golf. Gonna get by him. Ironic, a German guy is driving a German car. Irony, my friend. Be cruising down. Almost driving into the wall. Whoa, God, I'm driving in the dirt. One last lap, we can't really afford any mistakes. Quite the rush that we're totally not getting in our Honda RS, which honestly, they should pick a better car than this. Cruising off of turn down out of this turn. We got Ebony and Ebony. Ebony? Ebony and A. Barton are first and second. We are in third. So this is the last lap, so we're going to try to stuff it in here. Dear Lord, hopefully we'll get this guy here off this last turn. Hit the brakes, please. Please hit the damn brakes. Gonna be using the bump and run. Gonna take the lead. One thing y'all know is I'm a very aggressive racer on this game. And if the online features are still up, which I believe they are for this game, and if I decide to do any online races, or my internet connection doesn't suck, you'll probably expect a lot of this kind of racing. Let's go to race three. All right. Time to race our way around Willow Springs. Two laps, gonna make up 4.91 miles today. Got a Nissan, a Starlet, a Renault, and two other cars I don't know. All right. And I'd turn that around, down a bit because that song will get me blocked. I'm coming off of turn number four. Hopefully this song won't get me detected. Last turn and we're green at Willow Springs. Out down through the wide turn. This is a relatively high speed road course. However, you don't want to dip your wheels into the dirt because you will go around. And there are some odd vehicles in this game, which I'll kind of show off later after I beat this cup. And you try to get around the Hyundai, that thing that looks like a half retarded minivan, half Subaru. Coming off the high carousel and down to the fast part of the course. Sean Beasley and Nate Sutton are 1-2. And the rest of the people are behind me. Currently halfway up the pack. Hopefully we'll catch them in this next lap. And I'm really not... I'm really doing a really good job of commentary. Totally. I should be on a real Gran Turismo commentary team. It's like there's a 240 that's trying to cut us off. Oh, dear Lord. Gonna be doing a little bit of agricultural racing there. That corner has always been pretty tough for me on this track, so I'm kind of apprehensive, but then again, this is the Amateur Cup. They'll probably push me back on. And you're probably really stupid if you don't win a race in the Amateur Cup. Making our way down out of the carousel with a out-of-sync tachometer and our Honda RS, and we're going to try to pass this guy, who I believe is driving a Mazda. Yep, Mazda Roadster. Going to give him the bump. Probably not something people do in real life racing like this, unless we're going to be getting to the NASCAR series, which I will be doing this a lot, doing the bump and runs I like to do. Making our way out of the bend, up the hill, here at Willow, and now down the backstretch. Sean Beasley looks to the inside. We're gonna do the block. He's gonna try to sniff a draft. And he's not going to get us. And this means crossover, over, got it. Now let's show off some of the odd choices for vehicles in this game. And believe me, there are some odd ones. But first, killers. Oh, it's going to be a pretty killer song. Coffee Break Challenge is now available, which I'll get to those next episode. Then I jump into the Novice Championship, then do License Tests. They are basically mini games with a twist. And you'll have to do those. We'll do those later after I finish the Novice stuff. Alright, let's look at the vehicle choice. Logical. Random, you know, cars that they threw together. They'll put together cars from third market companies such as AEM and things like that. Art Morrison. Buick. There's going to be some cars in there. Cadillac. Okay. Callaway. Alright. Chaparral. Most of this is going to be, you know, later in the episodes, like when I have enough money to blow on these cars. Chevrolets, we got the SSR, which literally nobody remembers, by the way. We have an El Camino in here. And for some reason, somebody thought it'd be cool to put a Silverado in this game. And we only get one color. Get some test cars, Le Mans cars. We have NASCAR. We got all the Gen 6 cars. So we got Stewart, Gordon, Montoya, Jimmy Johnson, and Dale Jr. You know, since it is Junior's final season, I'll probably pick Junior and maybe Jeff Gordon later. So we got Legit. If you want to watch me drive a car that looks like it came from Back to the Future, you can do just that. They put the Prowler, which is the ugliest car I've seen, and I used to have a toy car of that. And they put the Ford Ka, which has like 50 horsepower. So, somebody thought this was a good idea. And they put a Ford Lightning in this game. I don't know what, but this game just... I don't know what this game thought, you know, putting trucks in this game. But we're not getting down to it. So the rest are just relatively legit cars that you can see in the game. They put the Vibe in here. God, please gag me. And they put a Dodge Ram for some dumb reason. Bright white. That's seriously a damn color name. Alright. So these are most of these are relatively legit cars. But look at Honda. The lifestyle. 29 horses. The Today G, 30 horsepower, and then the S500, most of these are below the 70 horsepower range, in fact, all of them are. That's the reason they're so damn cheap. And then you get some good stuff with the Fit, a 1. They put a Honda Element in here. Why? Again, why? Is this a racing game or, you know, the first car simulator? Oh, my. This was funny. They put a minivan in this game.
Hey, Joni. Hey, guys. Let's go to soccer practice.
What are we going to...
Hey, guys. You want to go to a soccer practice? I didn't know soccer practice was at Willow Springs. That's because I'm racing. Racing. Shut up, Billy.
And this is actually worth money. That's the scary part. Then you got the rest of the relatively legit cars. You got some of the S200s, the NSX, some rally cars. Oh my god, Pikes Peak cars. Most of these are just relatively legit. I kind of question the choices of putting some of these cars in this game. Like, the Prius is mind-blowing to me. The Prius in a racing game with sports cars. Mindfuck. Prius, no. I'd rather drive a Leaf. So we look through the rest of the cars. We got a Supra, so it'll probably be some Paul Walker. That'll be a Paul Walker episode I'm going to dedicate that to. They put a Tacoma in this game. For some dumb reason. Oh my god. They put Land Rover. Land Rovers in this game are apparently fast. By miracle of God. So, if you guys like this opening episode of Gran Turismo 6, why not give it a like? Throw some comments. Click that subscribe button. Follow me on social media. Ooh, wow. Follow me on social media. And I hope you guys have a good day.